Hey guys, how are you doing? Welcome to my second FlossTube video. I just want to say thank you guys so much. I think everybody kind of has this idea that when they start making these videos that nobody's gonna watch them, or maybe one person will watch it and you might get a like or a comment or a subscriber, but to have as many viewings and as many likes and as many comments and subscribers as I got, I'm thrilled. You guys are amazing. And I guess that just goes to show that, Stitchers are some of the most amazing people out there. So thank you guys so much. I'm excited to be doing another video because you guys, again, with the inspiring and the encouraging and everything else. So thank you again. I kind of only worked on two whips this week, so I'm going to run through those. And I also figured that I would take today to show some more of my finished projects, because I only have, like I say, two projects that I worked on to show you kind of progress on. So I have a little bit of haul, and yeah, I have some notes down on my desk in front of me, so if I'm looking down, I do apologize. I figured I would try and plan this video out a little bit better than I did the last one. So, yeah, we're kind of going to wing it and kind of going to use my notes and we'll see how it goes. I also do want to apologize. It's a little bit cloudier here today, so my lighting's not quite as good, but I'm going to try and make the most of it. I also do have to run out of the house. I have an appointment also this morning. I might have to do some more filming afterwards, but I'm going to try and get through the bulk of my video right now. I do have some fully finished objects that I'm going to have to dig out in order to show you. So I'm thinking that's the part that I might have to edit in later. And yeah, like I say, we'll go from there. So I'm going to start off with the two projects that I actually worked on. The first one is the Lakeside Needlecraft stitch along, the fantasy style. So I did work a little bit more on that. I did, if you remember, get the August block finished last month. So I was just working on the border just in the mornings for about an hour to an hour and a half every morning. So I'm going to try and insert a photo or a video snippet of where it looked last time. So hopefully I can manage to do that. If not, this is where I am this week. So again, this is stitched on 28 count, I believe, Crystal Pansy by Picture This Plus. So I did work, like I say, some on the border on this side. I actually have the page, what would it be? Page number four, I believe, pretty much completely finished. So I'm just gonna show you a little bit closer. So there's some little butterflies and a lightning bolt and a heart. And that's about as far as I got. This last little curly Q right here, this is actually the corner. So I pretty much reached the bottom of this one, and I am just loving this. Like, I love this border, and it's so easy. Well, I shouldn't say it's easy, but it gives a nice break from doing confetti heavy pieces, and the amount of detail that you get just from a couple colors is awesome. So that's where I left off on this one this week. So I'm gonna keep carrying on with the border and start doing some more circles, I think. Still again in the morning, and yeah, that's my plan for this one until the next block comes out. So I'm hoping I can get a fair amount more accomplished this week. So that is that one. The other thing that I worked on was my Chatelaine. Again, I'm going to try and insert a picture or a video snippet of where it was last week. And I actually got quite a bit of stitching done on this one. My husband was sick last weekend, so I encouraged him to spend the day resting on the couch and not doing a lot around the house. So that kind of gave me a little bit of guilt-free stitching last Sunday. So I got almost a full day worked on this. So this is where it is this week. And last week I had about half of this filigree corner kind of done, and I managed to get the rest of this filigree in this corner finished. I kind of had some problems sleeping last night. I've been awake since 2:30 in the morning, and I got the majority of this little butterfly done this morning while my husband was still sleeping. So I'll just try and zoom in a little bit. So that's where I've gotten to on this one. That little butterfly, I have one more color of blue to put in, and then the back stitching, and then he's done. So I think what I'd like to do, like I said in my last video, there's a larger butterfly that goes center here, and I'd like to get that done before I swap out, if I swap out. Oh, I forgot to mention too, I also did this row of flowers there. It's kind of back stitching and then little Jessica stitches for the flower heads. So it's kind of tedious, but it looks really good when it's all done. So yeah, I should get that little butterfly finished sometime today, hopefully. And like I say, I'll make a start on that larger butterfly and try and get some on that one done. So that's kind of the top half where it is. So that is that one. I think when I switch out that one, I think I might actually work on my Halloween Kitty mandala. I actually had Church Mouse Stitches comment that she'd like to see how much I kind of have done on that one. So I did pull out that one, so I can kind of show how that one's stitching up. So this is Halloween Kitty Chatelaine mandala. The color of the fabric's not, it's more, it's a darker green than what it's showing up as. So, and this is on 28 Can Lugana Monster Mash by Picture This Plus. There we go. So that's how much I have done on this one. I have to say, those cats are terrible. They're stitched with that Edmar satin thread. And I'm trying to get an accurate color. That's a little bit better for the fabric. I believe I was supposed to only use one strand of thread for the cats. My coverage wasn't very good though with only one strand, so I ended up doubling it. And I had ordered the kit from European Cross Stitch, and it had only come with one skein of the Edmar rayon, and each cat takes a full skein. And you wouldn't think that they would be that much floss to do each cat, but I had to order some more in. And it just, I'm not really crazy about it. I think if I were to do it all over again, I would probably just pick out a nice black silk thread to do it with, but I have 2.5 cats done. I'm not pulling it out now, so it's just going to be how it is, and hopefully, I did find that I ordered a laying tool, and I started using that, and that helped it look a little bit better, but I'm still not crazy to work on it, so, yeah, so that's how this one is looking. I do have to say, though, too, the Halloween Kitty mandala is I shouldn't say significantly smaller, but it is smaller than the butterfly lace, and there isn't as many specialty stitches in it as well. So if you're looking for kind of an intermediate chatelaine design, maybe this one of the medium-sized mandalas might be a good place to start if you don't want to do one of the minis. If none of those are kind of interest to you, the medium ones, from what I can tell, they're not quite a specialty stitch heavy as some of the bigger ones. That's just my kind of opinion. So anyways, I am thoroughly enjoying this one as well too, but like I say, the cats are a little frustrating, but hopefully I can pull it out after I'm done another large butterfly on my other one and get some progress on this one as well too. So yeah, and I love it, and I'm really happy with the fabric that I chose. There's some cat eyes that go around it, and they're green, and I think it's going to complement the fabric really well, so I'm looking forward to getting to that, and I might maybe even jump ahead and start working on those for a little bit, because I'm curious to know how that's going to look when they're kind of stitched on there. So that is that one. So yeah, that's kind of what I've been up to all week. I feel like I've gotten a lot of stitching done, but I always feel like I should be getting more done too, so as I'm sure everybody else does too. So slowly but surely they'll get finished. So anyways, I do actually have some finishes that I've done. So maybe I'll show those, and then, like I say, I do have a little bit of haul, and yeah, and then I'll have to maybe come back and splice together some videos of my other finishes as I slowly drag them out. So you'll also have to forgive me, a lot of these are older, so that was before I would keep track of the fabric and the count and like anything that I changed on them. So please bear with me. I might not have all the information that you're kind of looking for, but I'm going to do the best that I can. I actually don't even have all of my finishes. Some of them obviously were given away as gifts. I didn't take photos of them before I gave them away or anything. So I do have more finishes, but this is kind of what I have for right now. So, and again, I do apologize because I think, as I said last time, unless I frame them or do something with them right away, they just kind of get folded up and shoved in a drawer altogether. So they are a little wrinkled. Some of them still have hoop marks on them because I'm not going to wash them just to shove them in a drawer. So when I do decide to actually do something with them, I will take them out and press them and wash them and make them look all pretty, but until then I can't be overly bothered to do it. So I'm going to start off with one of my smaller finishes. I did this one last year, I believe. This is one of the Clouds Factory. This is the very first Biscornu that I have ever done. This is the Nevermore Biscornu. And it's got Edgar Allan Poe on it, and the little spider web in the middle. Sorry, I should have taken out all my pins before I did this. A lot of these pins I've gotten from Just Pins, I believe, is where I got them from. I just picked them up at my local needlework shop, these guys, and so these ones came all as a set. The little bird and the little checkerboard. And then these guys. These all came as a set. So, but I thought they were kind of cute. So I picked those ones up, and then I got these ones as another set. I gave a couple of them away actually to a friend of mine. There we go. I had actually made her a biscornu as well. I had bought the Nightmare Before Christmas chart from Clouds Factory, and I had stitched, kind of used this pattern as like a guideline, and so I had stitched a Nightmare Before Christmas character in each of the corners. And I had kept the inside spider web from this pattern, and then I just kind of made my own little motifs all around it. And it turned out really good. So I gave her a couple of my pins as well to go with it. So I love the spider web in the middle of this. I love it. It's so detailed and so simple, and it's so effective, I think. So that's this side, and then on the other side, it's got another spider web and just some purple flowers. It's got so. Yeah, so, and I should say too, I got these two pins. They're so cute. So cute from the Primitive Hare. I am a huge fan of Little Red Riding Hood, so I saw these on Stitching Bits and Bobs website and had to get them, so. And they're just so cute. I love them. And then, oop, this guy is flat on the back, and then she's got her little hood. So, but they're so cute. So that's one of my finishes. Like I say, and then after I had done this one, I had done another biscornu and I had given it away, so. So I got two of them done that year. So the next finish that I have, ooh, excuse me, is from a magazine. I don't know which one it was. I had bought it as a digital download, and I had the app for it. And for some reason, they switched their app around, and I couldn't access any of the magazines that I had purchased. I was really disappointed, and I was very thankful that I had finished this in time, before I got kind of locked out of the whole thing. But it's just a little fizzy moon. I stitched him. I'm not sure which fabric this is. But he is 2/2 full crosses, and I believe this is 28 count. I kind of did him as a trial to see how I would like the 2/2. That's a little bit better. He has so much backstitching in him, but he is so cute. I love him. So. And I did like the 2/2 on 28 count, but he is extremely thick. So I actually ended up doing a couple Heaven and Earth designs, 2/2 on 28. I have them actually in my pile here. And they turned out really good, like I say, very thick. But I think I found that I prefer 1/1 on 32 count to be a combination that I really enjoy. I have several of the Heaven and Earth started already. They're 2/2 on 25 count. I'm not gonna restart them or pull them out. I have too much time invested in them, so I'm just gonna carry on as I am. But I think for future starts, I'm gonna stick with the 1/1 on 32 counts. So, but there's that one. my little, like I say, Fizzy Moon. I don't remember exactly what he was called, but the next one that I did, I finished this one last year as well too. This one is called, excuse me, A Buzz for Blackberries. It's by the Sweetheart Tree. It came as a little kit, so it came with the fabric and the floss and the beads and everything as well too. So, and it was just a cute little finish. I think I did this in a weekend. I just wanted something simple to do and whatnot else. So I picked this up, and like I say, I did this in about a weekend. It's funny. I don't know if I'm the only one that does this, but it seems to me the simpler the design is, the more mistakes I make. It's almost like I think it's easy and I stop focusing and then I run into problems. So I think one of the bees in this one, I ended up frogging about 3 times because I kept misplacing him. So ridiculous. But yeah, give me like a intense confetti area piece of a pattern and I seem to do just fine during that. So I don't know. So that's this one. And this was a really fun chart as well, too. I'd actually like to get some more of them, and I have a couple more in my stash already, but they're just kind of quick, and I love the bead work in this. I don't know if you can tell, but the berries are three-dimensional, and they were really cute to do. So, and really easy. Again, they had really good explanation for how to make the blackberries. And I have to say as well too, I had bought it as a kit and I have tons of beads left over, and I didn't have a problem running out of thread even with frogging the little bit that I did. They were very generous with the amount of floss and everything that they gave for their kits. So the next one that I have is the first Chatelaine that I actually did, and it was just a freebie. I actually just checked on Martina's website before I started doing this video, and I actually didn't see this one anymore, so I don't know if it's offered anymore, but it's just a little cute scarecrow freebie pattern. Well, it was a freebie pattern. Like I say, I didn't see it on there anymore, but it was kind of cute. I did it on a yellow. I want to say this is Pampas. I could be wrong on that. Don't quote me. From Picture This Plus. And I love this little snail at the bottom. He's so cute. Him and the little bird. So. But that's that one. Like I said, that was the first Chatelaine that I did. The next one that I have to show you is from a company called Nimu. I think that's how you say it. And I'm going to butcher the name of the pattern. I don't know French at all to save my life. Le Chambos, I believe. And I stitched this last Halloween or the Halloween before. I had him actually finish for Halloween. And he is so cute. And this is stitched on, I want to say 25 or 28 count Murky by Picture This Plus. And I love the fabric. I love this fabric, so. So that's how he turned out. The pumpkin and the frog are my favorite of this whole chart. I absolutely love the colors in them. So, and the little spider is pretty adorable too. So that is that one. I'll show this one again just super quickly. This is the Victoria Sampler Trick or Treat. This was, like I say, my first attempt at doing hard anger. So there was that one. I showed from my last video, and same with Raven, the Nora Corbett, which, hi cat, hi bud, hi, you want to come sit on my lap? Ooh, my one fur baby, Sterling, and he's the not sit still one. Kick you, go down. So there's those two. I won't spend a lot of time on them because I showed them off quite a bit last video. Kitty. And there's birds outside my window, so he's pretty excited right now. We have a lot of trees in our backyard, so we get quite the array of birds outside. So anyways, the next one I'm going to show is my first Mirabilia that I ever did. This is Mermaid of the Pearls, which I'm sure you all are familiar with. Ah, kitty. What? Kitty. So this is Mermaid of the Pearls. This one took me a few months to stitch and like 5 years to get all the beads on. I hated beading at the time and I didn't have a very good setup for it, so I just tried to avoid it. And yeah, so she was unfinished for a very long time. But this is Mermaid of the Pearls. And I'm so happy that I have her done now. She's so pretty. I still think that she's one of my favorite mermaids. And she has so many beads on her. It's ridiculous. And like I say, this is the very first Mirabilia that I ever did. And I did her, I would say probably, I want to say 10 years ago I did her. So I never dreamed of changing the pattern. So I never would think to do the skin 1/1 or, I remember they couldn't find the exact fabric that the pattern called for. And I was so stressed out. I'm like, this isn't what it called for. What if it doesn't look good? Like, what if? And she turned out beautiful on this fabric. I don't know what it was called, but the lady at the store was very reassuring that she would be fine, and this is very close to what is actually called for in the pattern. So, but I mean, you know, 30 years ago, nobody knew, it was so limited with what you had, right? Like, cross stitching was like little teddy bears and samplers, and there wasn't half the amount of threads or fabric or even patterns that there are available today. So, I mean, I think this craft has just come so far. And like I say, I was so stressed out that this wasn't what the pattern called for, so I just stressed. I mean, now I know better. So, thanks to all of you. And, you know, basically telling somebody that it's okay to, like, change something if you don't like it. So, and I find that that's what's so great about this community as well, too, is, I mean, like I say, the encouragement is just awesome. So, the next one I did is my ink circles. This is Metamorphosis. And I did this one on Queen Anne's Lace. It is a Wychult, I believe, fabric. Hand-dyed linen, not linen, even weave. This is the same fabric that I'm doing my butterfly lace on. And I didn't use the recommended colors. I used hand-dyed silks from Vicky Clayton. I used her silks. I had gotten a random pack of, I think it came with like 12 different colors I had ordered, and I just randomly picked out colors that I liked from there. So that is that one. This one I'd actually really like to turn into a pillow one day. So I'm hoping to get that done in the future, because I don't have nearly enough wall space to hang all my finishes up, so I gotta be a little creative and do other things with them. The next one is one of the stitch-alongs from the Heaven and Earth ooh, excuse me, Heaven and Earth bulletin board. This is the 2013 stitch-along. I chose the Theater of the Absurd by Ciro Marchetti, and that's how this one turned out. This, I believe, was the little fizzy moon that I had done was my test project for this one. I had done this one on 28 count because I wanted him to be really small. And I am really happy with the way he turned out. That looks a little bit better. I really like the mask in the corner here. The detail in that piece is just, it's really incredible in such a small area. That was this one. And yeah, like I say, he's very, very thick, so I not too sure what I want to do with this one yet, but would like to have him displayed somewhere in my house one day. So there's that one. The next one that I did is also a Heaven and Earth Designs. This one is by Stephanie Pumanla. She's one of my favorite artists. I love her stuff so much. This is Storykeep White Ninetail Fox. And oop. Again, this is done 2/2 full crosses on 28 count. Just a plain mushroom Lugana. I really like the mushroom color for the Heaven and Earth. I find it's really easy to see the holes and the stitches, and for the pictures that I've chosen, I haven't had a problem with the threads from the actual piece blending into the fabric. There's that one. And I'm really happy with the way this one turned out as well too. There's so much detail in this bottom part. I did have a little bit of problem with this chart though. There were two arrows, two dark arrows, and one faced left and one faced right, and they were right beside each other, and I kept forgetting which symbol I was working on. And I did have a little bit of frogging to do on this piece repeatedly, but it's all done now, and the end effect is worth it. But it was a little frustrating at the time, having to frog on 28 count over two, or two strands over one. But like I say, he's all done now. This is another bulletin board stitch along. I believe this was from 2010, 2011. This was the very first one that, no, sorry, the second one that I had done. This is by Linda Ravenscroft, and it's Blue Moon. And she is stitched, just go back a bit. She is stitched 2/2 on, I want to say, 28 count linen, and the color is Karma by Silk Weavers. So she's quite a bit larger. And you can see like the detail still turns out like fantastic in these charts. And it doesn't matter if it's on 14 count, which is what this one would be the equivalent of, or 28 count. Like it's just beautiful. So I think these two are about the same size. Actually, this one is actually a bigger chart, and you can tell like the size difference. It's ridiculous. And this one was the Blue Moon, was about 2.5 to 3 pages. And this one, the chart was actually a full page wide and then a little bit by, I want to say, 3.5 pages down. So you can tell the size difference. And they both turned out great. So if you can only see to stitch on 18 or 14 count Aida, that shouldn't discourage you from doing one of the Heaven and Earth design pictures. They are going to end up bigger, but you're still going to end up with amazing detail doing them. Yeah, that's my two cents on that. So, like I say, you shouldn't let your eyesight or anything deter you from trying it at least, right? So, the next two that I have are two Christmas patterns. They are from an old magazine. Cross Stitch and Country Crafts. Exactly which issue I'm not sure. So this is one of the very first pictures that I did on linen. So excuse me. My nose is a little runny today. So this is one of the very first pictures that I did on linen. And there's a little reindeer. And I have to say, this is probably one of the very first times I ever did, I don't know if you'd call Lazy Daisy stitch like a specialty stitch, but I was pretty intimidated by them when I was doing these patterns. So I did this one, and actually when I went to mount these, I had done them, I don't know if anybody remembers the sticky boards. And there's actually some French knots in them. There's two there. And when I removed it from the sticky board, it actually pulled the French knots through. So I'd like to try and track down which issue this pattern was from and redo the French knots in them because I don't remember. I could probably wing it, but I'm not sure which color thread the French knots were. And I could kind of see where they were because it left a pretty decent size hole there. But I have this one, and then there's a little Santa as well that goes with it. And he's so cute. He is so cute. But I'd also like to finish these maybe into some seasonal pillows or just something that I can kind of bring out during the holidays. So, and he has some Lazy Daisy stitches on his suit there too, so. But yeah, I remember really enjoying those two projects. I was pretty new to stitching at the time, so I don't know. I think just maybe the excitement of trying something besides Aida, like actually doing linen, was probably exciting. I don't know. But they're so cute. I still really like them, and I'm not a huge Christmas fan, but I love those two pieces. So the next two that I have are two Butternut Road. The first one I'm going to show you is called Spirit Dancer, and that is this one. And she's so pretty too. There's so many. When I did this one, I remember thinking, oh my God, there's so many beads on here. And when I compared this to the Mermaid of the Pearls, there's like hardly any on here at all. It's crazy, but her neck piece is pretty much all beads right there. And then it's got these bigger turquoisey beads on there as well too. But I absolutely love the green background on this one. So I'm really happy with her and the way she turned out. A lot of these older patterns too, I didn't even keep the patterns or anything. I just kind of, oh, well, I'm done. I'll never stitch this again. And I just, you know, got rid of everything. You know, I really wish I would have held on to some of that stuff. And I mean, you can always pass it on. And like, who knows, like some of these older patterns, like if they become retired or, you know, just hard to get, it's kind of nice to, even if you're done it or whatever, to still kind of have that pattern in your stash for sentimental sake, I guess. Or, you know, maybe that's just me and I'm weird, but I don't know. But anyways, the other one that I did was kind of the companion piece, which is Earth Dancer. And this one I had actually done first. But she has a few beads on her as well too. I love doing the dream catcher behind her. Again, this was like 20 years ago, and I was so excited to be using like a variegated thread. I just thought it was the neatest thing. So she's got some beads on her neckline too. Kitty! And again, if I knew what I knew now, I would probably have done the skin one over one. One over one, I would have done the skin and just experience, right? So those are all my finishes that I have that aren't massively huge and framed. Like I say, I'm gonna go dig out some of those and I'll try and splice them in after this. Okay guys, these are just gonna become some short videos. These are two other finishes that I've done. This first one is based on the artwork by Lisa Iris. It started by White Willow Stitching, and this is her Scorpio. I had done this one for myself, and this was actually my first time ever doing a full coverage piece. This was also back before I knew better, and whatever the pattern called for was what I did it on. So this is actually on 14 count Ada. I really actually want to restitch this on a 25 count even weave, and I just think that the detail would be so much better. It still looks beautiful, don't get me wrong. But it is quite large. I love the frame and the matting on it, so I think if I were to redo it, I would just order new mats. I would keep the same color and I'd keep it in the same frame because I love that frame. So I'm just going to zoom in a little bit. Please excuse my shaky hand handheld camera skills. But I love this frame. This has like a gothic-y kind of feel to it. And I think it really works with the picture. So that is Scorpio. And I also did her other piece, which is Cancer. This is, again, based on the artwork by Lisa Iris, charted by White Willow Stitching. I will put a link to them at the bottom of this video. So I had done the Scorpio for myself, obviously, because I'm a Scorpio, and I had done the Cancer for my mom, because she's obviously a Cancer, so. But I really like the way that they both turned out. I think the charting is actually really good on these, and they're not as confetti heavy as the Heaven and Earth. But yeah, the detail on her is really, really good as well too. Like her necklace just looks really good. And her headband and like even just the water behind her. So I'm really happy with the way both of these turned out. Like I say, they were both kind of my first attempt at doing a full coverage piece. And yeah, they're both stitched on 14 count Aida. So yeah, like I say, really detailed, even though it is a bigger count. So those are those two. I'm just gonna snip this video short and I'm gonna try and dig out a couple more projects and I will be right back. Okay, so here's another finish I did. This is by Cross My Heart Incorporated. It's an older pattern. The actual artist was Sherry Step Ewu, I believe is how you say her name. I could be totally wrong and totally butchering it. But this is the Fire Dragon. And this was stitched on, I don't remember what count, probably 28 count, 2/2 black even weave. So this is the Fire Dragon. And it was kind of nice because a lot of this isn't stitched, like all the black obviously isn't stitched. But that's kind of a bit of a close-up with him. So that's the Fire Dragon. And then I also did the Earth Dragon as well. So she's got, there's actually four of them. There's Earth, Air, Water, Fire. So I have two of the four done. I actually have the patterns for the other two, and I've made a start on Air Dragon. He is probably my oldest whip ever. Not so much love for him lately, but I do want to get the whole set finished. So this is the Earth Dragon, again by the same same pattern company and same designer. And I absolutely love him. He is my favorite. I just love the colors. Love the colors in him. And actually with both of these, like I say, they are older patterns. So they didn't actually give a floss usage list, and I ran into a problem with both of these. There was a main color in both of them that I ended up running out of about halfway through. I used up an entire skein and had to go out and buy another skein. And for both of these projects, there was a dye lot issue, and it was noticeable for me. So there was a lot of frogging involved with both of these pictures. So I made sure when I kitted up the other two that I bought doubles of each skein just to make sure, because I don't want to frog out a skein of an entire color ever again, because that was terrible. So this is actually the Air Dragon. This is just the cover photo. So that's what he's going to look like. I've started working on him already. The mountain range behind him, though, is all tent stitch, and I'm really not crazy about it. I am going to do it, though, because, like I say, I want the whole set done. And I'm just going to flip over the pattern quickly, because it actually has all four of them on the back. And I couldn't actually find the chart for this one, but that's what the Water Dragon looks like. And I really like him as well too. So I'm going to finish up the Air Dragon, hopefully one of these days, and then I'm going to start working on Water Dragons. So, and I just have one more to show you guys, and that is it for my whips. And there's my cat. There's kitty one, and a very sleepy kitty number two. So, I'm gonna go drag out that last finish, and I will see you guys in a bit. Okay guys, so this is my last finish that I have for you. This was actually the first haid that I had ever, not the first one I started, but the first one I finished. And this is by Jasmine Beckett Griffith. This is her Portal of Fantasy 2, so she was actually a pretty quick stitch as far as haids are concerned. So I think it was about six charting pages, but obviously they weren't full pages. So, and it was actually a circular chart. I didn't have to crop any of it when I framed it. So this is how she turned out. I'm really happy with her. There's so much detail. I love her eyes. Like, her eyes are just beautiful, so. Oh, kitty. I woke him up, I think, when I showed him in the last little clip. Get your head down. Come on. So, this is how she turned out. Like I say, I'm really happy with her. And got her framed in some round mats. And yeah, that's... I'm going to talk a little bit about my haul that I got. I'm a little upset with my order from 123 Stitch. Nothing against them. They shipped it, I want to say, at the end of last month. And it's actually been sitting in customs in Vancouver for probably about 13 days. So I'm a little annoyed. It is finally on its way here to Edmonton for me. But yeah, I was really concerned. I kept following the tracking number, and by day 10, I'm like, why is it not left Vancouver yet? Like, I don't understand what's going on. And you would think I would know, considering I work for Canada Post, but you know, I didn't think that it would get stopped by customs for whatever reason, but it did. So hopefully it will be here in this next week, and then I can show you some of the stuff that I got with that order. It's been so long, I don't even really remember what's in there. I know I ordered some beading needles and some Nymo thread. Those were the two things that I needed to purchase. And then, of course, I had to make the shipping worthwhile, so I threw some extra goodies in there. So, yeah, I'm looking forward to seeing exactly what's in there. So, I did make a stop the other day at my L&S. If anybody's ever in Edmonton, they need to check out the Craft Connection. She's got, for a little store, she's got quite the selection in there. She's got lots of different patterns and whatnot else, and she carries a full line of Gloriana threads and dinky dyes and watercolors. So she's got a lot of specialty threads, which is really good, right? I mean, there's nothing wrong with ordering them online, but I don't know if I'm the only one that you can go there and you can pick out two skeins and they're completely different sometimes. And the threads are kind of one thing that I really kind of like to see, because I mean, you could have a choice of five of the same color and you might like one of the five more than the other four. I don't know. I'm, again, being weird, but I kind of like to see my threads before I buy them. So anyways, I ended up stopping in, like I say, the other day. My very exciting purchase, floss away bags, very important. Of course, I couldn't just get a bag of floss away bags. So I was actually watching, whose video was it? Trixie Stitches First of all, thank you very much for watching my last video, and thank you for helping me out with my shadow lane. I love the suggestion of keeping the crystals off and doing the rest of the beading as I do it, so maybe I'll give that a go my next time. But anyway, she was showing off a chart called Where Hearts Rest by Brenda Gervais, and I loved it. It was so cute, and when I went in to get my floss away bags, they actually had this one on the wall. So that's that one. And so I saw it and I had to buy it because it's so cute. And it says, Bird's Nest Where Hearts Rest. And it's so cute. I love it. So that was my little tiny bit of haul. I also got an email from Martina about her new blog post. This was last Sunday, I believe, I got it. And at the end of it, she said, there's a hidden clue with three words in this blog, so if you can guess them or piece them together, you get 20% off of your order. And she was only offering it to 20 people. So, of course, like a crazy person, I got obsessed over trying to figure out what the code was. And I think that was just it. I wanted to know that I could figure it out, and I actually did. And then I'm like, oh, well, I guess I should buy something now. I wasn't planning on it, but I mean, 20% off. How do you say no to that, right? So I did make very good use of 20% off. I'm going to have to insert some pictures, but I ended up getting three mandalas and one of her beaded tiles. So I ended up getting her summer mandala, and I will insert a picture. Hopefully here. And then I ended up getting the Herbularis and the Tintorium mandalas, and I will insert pictures of those as well here as well. And then I also splurged and got the beaded scarab tile because I have been eyeballing that one forever. So I will insert a picture of that one as well. Here. So those were the four charts that I got from Chatelaine with my 20% off. I don't know exactly when I'm going to be kitting those up. I have a couple other shadow lanes that I have all the supplies for already, which will obviously be taking priority over ones that I don't have anything for. But like I say, 20% off, it's hard not to take advantage of that. So I did get those four charts, and like I say, I do have an order from Stitching Bits and Bobs as well on the way. So hopefully I will get that. I'm not keeping my fingers crossed that it's going to be anytime soon, but hopefully this month, maybe towards the end or maybe early next month. We'll see. But I should have my order from 123 Stitch hopefully this week. So I will have a little bit more haul to show you for that as well too. I'm going to go, and I'm at 49 minutes already for this video, guys. That's kind of crazy. So I'm going to try and piece together some more video of some of my other finishes. Like I say, they are fully framed, and I'm going to insert them maybe here, maybe at the end of all my other projects that I showed you. I will try and get those in at some point or another today, get this uploaded, and I just want to thank you guys again so much. You guys are all fantastic, and I appreciate all the encouragement and all the kind thoughts and all the comments and everything else. You guys are really awesome, and I just can't thank you enough. So I hope you enjoy this video as well too. And I, again, I'm hoping to get maybe a third project on the go this week, so I will have a little bit more, a couple different projects to show you in my next video instead of just my one chatelaine and my, like I said, needlecraft cell. So keep your fingers crossed for me, and hopefully I will have another productive stitchy week. And take care, you guys. Thanks again for watching, subscribing, and commenting, liking, and I hope you all have a great stitchy week, and I will see you next Saturday, hopefully. Thanks. Bye-bye.